Today, hundreds of female athletes flocked to Oceanside, California for the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro. Centered around a QS 6000 all-women surf competition, the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro showcases women in action sports and celebrates female empowerment, all while having a ton of fun. Up next, it's surfing, music, food, and fun at the 2016 Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro. Welcome to beautiful Oceanside, California, home of the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro. It's going to be an amazing weekend here in Oceanside, celebrating all aspects of women's action sports culture. From surfing and skating to live music and amazing food, there's plenty to do and see at this incredible festival. And at the center of it all, a six-star surf competition that has attracted some of the best female athletes in the world for almost 10 years.
Really great to see all the best women in the world in one spot.
It's definitely bigger and bigger every year.
It's really cool to see the event just evolve as more girls do it, the surfing gets better, and the event, as it's grown and just gotten bigger overall, and there's been more support, more sponsors. It's really been kind of fun to be a part of that journey.
The vibe here is really good, and all the women come from around the world to compete at this event, since it's a top star for the qualifying series, and it's definitely a great comp.
Every year that I come back to the Supergirl Pro, I'm just so excited to see all the lively faces and all the girls on the beach. It's such a feminine, empowering event, I'd like to say. Like, everyone is there for each other, and I get so much inspiration off the little girls that come up for autographs. Supergirl kind of represents something for women that is amazing to be a part of, and it represents us being strong and superior and just elevating our talents, and I feel like that is amazing to be a part of.
We're basically treated like princesses here, and it's nice to have that when, you know, you're in a contest and competing and trying to win.
There's skating now, and there's music, and just so many activities for just the girls to come down and enjoy. You know, you can get your hair braided, and you can go watch your favorite skater and then turn around and watch your favorite surfer. So it's really, really unique.
The surfing's getting harder, and the girls are getting younger and better.
Coming down yesterday and watching all the girls in the first couple of rounds was awesome. It's all the younger girls, and they're doing so well, and it's just the future of the sport, so it's amazing to see.
By far is the biggest event for women, and when we first started serving this event, it was still, you know, in the early stages of that whole progressive women upbringing of competitive surfing, and it's nice to see the progression of the girls and how many more girls there are. It's come a long way, and I'm happy to be in the mix still.
The Supergirl is a really big event, especially for the girls on the qualifying series to qualify for the championship tours, which is the dream tour, made of the top 17 best women surfers in the world.
I remember when I was a junior pro and it turned into a QS, and every year it's gone above and beyond expectations for a women's event, and I'm still happy to be in the mix, still progressing and learning a lot, and continuing my role every year at Supergirl.
They're one of the highest rated surf comps on the qualifying series for us ladies, and if you can do well here, it's such a good result for the overall rankings to qualify for the World Tour next year.
You start to see who might qualify next year. Once you do well in this event, you stay at the top of the rankings.
chances are that you really are going to end well at the end of the year. This event's really important for me, and I've definitely been buckling down and hoping to get a good result here to set up my year.
Points really start to count, and each heat is really important.
To have this event to, I guess, be the biggest women's surf event that's out there is just obviously something that's so important to women surfing, and just to all the girls out there that want to just come down and just kind of be inspired and want to get active and leave the beach just excited to either surf or, you know, get into music or like just do something healthy and active and have fun, yeah.
I'm just excited for everything. It's definitely one of the best put together events, and I get to come and perform in front of all my Californians, which is nice because I spend like 10 months out of the year in other countries. So it's always nice to come back to a home sort of turf, I'd say.
Over 100 hopeful surfers have gathered in Oceanside this weekend, but only one will get to wear the coveted pink cape. When we come back, the competition heats up to find out who will be crowned the next Supergirl. The Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro is being brought to you by Paul Mitchell Professional Salon Products. Paul Mitchell, live beautifully. By Essentia Ionized Alkaline Water, get ionized with perfect hydration. By Kind Snacks, makers of delicious healthy snacks from ingredients you can see and pronounce. And by Supergirl, the lifestyle brand for girls that celebrate female strength and empowerment. As athletes from all over the world roll into Oceanside, they first head over to Master's Kitchen and Cocktail for the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro Premiere Party.
What's great about this event is that it's all about the fun, and win, lose, coming down here is always a great time, and it makes me feel good because I feel like, again, it's all about uplifting women and all about girl power.
Oceanside's such a fun wave. I think I heard this morning was like barreling out here, and yeah, I always have fun here.
Yeah, the wind kind of comes up in the afternoon and it definitely becomes challenging, but I guess that's a part of competing, and competing is the biggest challenge.
The waves can get huge, and you know, that's exciting, I think, because the girls have to step up and try and do big turns, and they'll get rewarded and get those big scores.
From low tide to high tide, it changes a lot. The peak shifts a lot from right next to the pier to a little to the left, and you really just have to focus on the waves and watch the waves right before your heat, because it can change so fast. You can't be too dedicated to your game plan. You've got to have an open mind to move around if your spot's not working, and I think it's a great challenge. It really keeps you on your toes. You can't make any mistakes. You can't go on bad waves. You really need to find those two gems. And I love it. I like the challenge.
The conditions change so much, and we have the pier, which is a factor. So a lot of times waves will run through the pier, and that's a little bit uncomfortable because they're surrounded with barnacles. So there's a little bit of like an X factor of, can you shoot the pier? Are you far enough away from it?
There's a lot of waves coming through right now, but you definitely have to be really selective because not every wave is good. It's actually really, really hard out there, but you know, there's so much opportunity, and I'm really stoked I found a couple good waves.
The Sunday morning sunrise revealed the start of the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro Round of 16. In Heat 1, it was two-time Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro winner Sage Erickson against Maude Lacar.
He gets a nice snap, wraps it right back into the pocket, seeing the waves come together.
Sage has really scored some points on her backhand. Ooh, trying to sneak one in, at least trying to drop in on that Maude Lacar, giving it a look, and Sage picks it up. Two-time winner of the Supergirl Pro here. Thank you, Paul Mitchell, for having this event. And Sage really looking on point, comfortable here at Oceanside.
I attribute just to my family and friends being down here, and that heat was gonna be hard. Maude's been surfing so good, and I surfed with her in Cabo a bunch, and we were like practicing, so I knew she was gonna be tough, and luckily I got some decent waves and really happy to get to the quarters.
In Heat 2, Australian Laura Enever went head-to-head with young gun Mia Collins.
Miss Laura Enever from Australia right now on her forehand, racing down the line, generating board speed. She's got a nice open face to work with. Whap! Throws it around, lays it on back, and look at that core strength and those squats and all that dry land training working for her, holding on.
She just knew exactly that last hit and blows the tail out. Actually, her back foot came off, and she's laying in the water like you would if you're a water skier, and then comes back up. Great abs, great leg strength, yeah. And she rides out of that.
the conditions are a bit tougher today, but I was very nervous at the whole end of the heat because Mia's been surfing so well. I've been watching her free surf and she's doing amazing. So, yeah, future of surfing in America is looking good.
In Heat 3, it was 16-year-old Macy Callahan that challenged 18-year-old Mahina Maeda.
There she goes, looking to see what it's going to do on this one open face area. And you see, capitalizing on what that small wave, that knee-high at best, had to offer.
Surfing means the world to me, and to come over like the other side of the world and compete against the world's best is, yeah, it's amazing.
In Heat 4, Hawaiian surfer and 2013 Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro Champion Malia Manuel took on Dominique Barona of Ecuador.
Malia's been in the right place at the right time and capitalized on two of her three waves, some hearty scores. Here she goes one more time, right at you folks on the pier. You see how she gets that board up in some almost vertical and able to do that twice, generating the power, bringing that board back down towards the shore.
It's nice to come back every year and this event gets bigger and better, and Paul Mitchell does such a great job supporting women surfing and this event, and it's nice to have an event in America, you know. And it's nice to see all the little girls here and in the sun and in the ocean, and hopefully, you know, get motivated to stay active and healthy and love the surfing lifestyle.
I am a food junkie.
I am an influencer. I am powerful. And I'm a coffee lover.
I am sassy, cruisy, and hilarious.
I'm not good at these.
I am a surfer that's passionate and fun.
I am happy. I am energetic. I'm exciting. I'm fun.
I am inspired by others.
I am dedicated.
I am unique.
I am crazy. I am competitive. I am fun. Did I say fun? I don't know.
I am nice. I am a lover of people. And I am a lover of the Supergirl Pro.
I'm salty. That's what I am right now.
Oceanside's so cool, like the little town here, and it's so cute, and I love the really kind of cultured area, you know, everyone can kind of come here and enjoy, you know, where we are and what it has to offer.
This year we have the stage and the VIP area and the amazing food, and now we have great waves on offer for all weekend.
I love the Oceanside Pier, like it's a really good wave to surf. I think I know it really well, so I just feel at home when I come here.
It's really nice to have an event at home. You know, we don't have that many events in California. You know, my family can come down and it's close to home.
Just this event, it's all females and it's a really special time for us. So it's pretty cool to come down and just be involved and be a part of it.
We're halfway through the round of 16 and only four more girls will advance to the quarterfinals. But first, let's take a look at 14-year-old Caroline Marks in this kind Supergirl profile.
I'd say my life is pretty unique because I travel around the world and surf and do so many cool things that I guess maybe not a normal 14-year-old would do. I don't go to public school, like I'm homeschooled, and yeah. So being a surfer, you know, you gotta eat right and you gotta train. When I train, I do a lot of core training just to stay lean. I don't really lift any weights or anything. I'm pretty young for that, and I don't think I will. I just want to stay lean because we're always, you know, using our arms and surfing, and you definitely got to stay in shape, definitely a lot of cardio and stuff, so you just want to get up super early and surf, and you don't have time to like go get breakfast, so you'll just grab a snack like a Kind bar, so makes it way easier, so you have something in your body when you surf for 8 hours before you eat your first meal. So when people say, oh, you're gonna be the next world champ, I don't think it really puts pressure on me. I think it gives me a lot of confidence that people think I can do that, and I definitely believe in myself, and that's my ultimate goal. That's everyone's surfer's dream, you know, that is competing, and I think it definitely gives me more confidence than puts pressure on me. So yeah, it's pretty cool. I love when people say that. It's cool. I have 8 people in my family, my mom, my dad, Darren and Sarah, and 6 brothers and sisters. My oldest brother, Luke, he's definitely the nice one in the family. My other brother, Zach, started Grom Social when he was 11. It's like a social networking site for kids.
1 million and 5 million and so on.
Yeah, we launched a site, it went viral. It was awesome.
He's freakishly smart and kind of creepy sometimes because how smart he is. My other brother, Jack, he's just really nice and is just kind of down for anything.
Yeah, welcome to my crib, bro.
No,
He definitely has all the looks in the family. He took all the looks. My other brother, Dawson, he's like a crazy person. Will do anything. And my other sister, Victoria, she's definitely the diva in the house and gets whatever she wants. But that's how it's always going to be because she's the youngest. But she's such a good girl. And yeah, so they're all something special. They all have something special about them. Oh, family is everything to me. Like, without them, I would definitely not be where I am today.
Back in the round of 16, in Heat 5, Carolyn Marks faced off against the powerful Silvana Lima.
As we take a look at the backhand attack of the Melbourne Beach, Florida, now San Clemente surfer Carolyn Marks.
6.0. Yeah, nice one. Highest score of the Heat, and that with her 4.67 keeps Carolyn Marks in the lead.
I just knew I had to surf to my full ability and just get the best waves, and I'm really stoked I did.
In Heat 6, Holly Wan battled it out with the 2015 world champion, Carissa Moore.
No priority problem there, a couple of nice hits. Holly Wan, some powerful forehand gouges, staying with this towards the pier.
Holly Wan, with priority, she's looking at this wave, says no thanks, gives it on over to Carissa Moore. And you see the board generated speed that Dave was just talking about from three-time world champion Carissa Moore.
It might have been Caroline Mark's lucky leash. Right before the heat started, I noticed my leash was almost about to break, so she was kind enough to let me borrow hers. So, I credit it to her.
Heat 7 put Australian Nikki Van Dijk against Hawaiian Zoe McDougall.
Gets a little bit of air release. And able to maintain through the whitewash, emerges clean and upright. That one maneuver with the speed generated from the beginning, 6.67.
You know, whatever level you're at, you know, you can kind of like just make sure you always like push yourself. I mean, not too much, but like just so that you're enjoying yourself, and you know, being active is so important and it makes you feel amazing.
In the final heat of the round of 16, two-time winner of the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro, Coco Ho, faced off against Bronte McCulty.
Been learned and educated in the ways of surfing from her family. Longtime relative Don Ho, you certainly know that name, and look at that. I think she's looking for some applause early on, folks. Come on, Coco Ho.
What does Supergirl power mean to you?
Doing everything badass with a cheeky smile.
Keep the positive vibes coming for Coco Ho. Moving on to the next round.
Looking forward to the quarterfinals. In Heat 1, Sage Erickson versus Laura Enever. Heat 2, Malia Manuel versus Macy Callahan. Heat 3, Carissa Moore versus Carolyn Marks. And in Heat 4, Coco Ho against Nikki Van Dijk. Welcome back to the Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro. With the surf competition heating up, let's see what other rad events are going down in Festival Village.
So this is Cody Simpson. He's a musician. He's here performing at Supergirl. Cody, tell me what it's like to be here and be performing at this female event.
Oh, it's unreal, yeah. Love, obviously, being able to play music, you know, by the beach and everything. And sort of got a wave in this morning and watched, you know, a lot of the girls do their thing, and you know, it's been an awesome atmosphere to be able to come and play a gig at. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Jacob Ellis. I'm 10 times X Game gold medalist, and I'm here at the Supergirl event in Oceanside. We have a lot of amazing women out here today. We've got surfers, skaters, and now DJers. So come down and check out the action. It's amazing.
I do this a lot differently than most DJs. I don't plan my sets out at all. So I literally go up there with about 3,000 songs and I'm just dancing with you guys.
What's your inspiration? Who do you look up to in this industry?
Oh, so many. I love all types of music. So I feel like one set should be like not one type of music, because you have different types of people, you want different type of music.
As the surfers rest before the quarterfinals, we check in with the other brave girls thrashing over at the half pipe. The Supergirl Skate Pro presented by Active Ride Shop. In third place, Poppy Star Olsen. In second place, Jordan Barrett. And winning the event, Kisa Nakamura, but it's Jordan who made history.
So I'm the first girl to do both surf and skate at the Supergirl, and it's been an amazing experience. Like, I don't know, I'm just super stoked to be here. I did skate last year, and so I just kept going with skate and everything, and now I'm here.
The quarterfinals are on, and it's Sage Erickson against Laura Enever in heat one.
Laura Enever from Australia, solid first turn and gets unstuck off the back of her board. All right, look at this. Chopping off a piece of this pie, Sage Erickson, boom. And she gets complete on that wave. Make some noise, Sage Erickson.
I really wanted to go ride out there. I was watching some really fun rides, but then whenever I got on them, I seemed to just get caught behind and just couldn't make it around the section. So I kind of just scratched that and started going left at the end and just trying to get that connection to the shore. I had one wave that was a six, and then besides that, I think my seven other waves were like ones. And so I just kept trying and trying, and finally got a wave at the end and got another five, and Sage was struggling too. And yeah, it's always hard when you're in a heat and you're both struggling to get scores because you just want to put on a good performance for everyone. But I'm stoked that I ended up finding some after all those tries. Always hard surfing against a friend, especially like Sage. But yeah, no, I'm stoked to make a semis, and yeah, hopefully can get some more waves next heat.
On tour, the girls can develop some special relationships.
Hi, I'm Logan, this is Chloe. You remember when we first met, right?
Yeah, you didn't have that accent.
Yeah, but I'm Logan, so I have this really bad British accent. And the first time we met, it was actually in Biarritz in France, and we,
You lost your phone.
No way. We became these alter ego people, Logan and Chloe in Biarritz, and pretty much it was just because we wanted to not have to tell anyone our real names, but it's just stuck with us, and now it kind of comes out now every now and again. Oh, I can't surf.
I don't think Logan can surf. I don't think Chloe can surf. They can dance.
Yeah, they can dance. Mm-hmm. I can rap.
Logan can rap some Biggie Smalls.
Yeah, it was all a dream. It was all a dream. I used to rework up magazines, Salt and Pepper, and Heavy D up in the limousine.
In heat two, 15-year-old Macy Callahan dukes it out with Malia Manuel.
And Malia Manuel in the white going south. Going north is Macy Callahan. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for both these ladies starting things off here. And Callahan, I thought she was done, but this supercharger keeps impressing me. Front and center, turquoise bottoms, pink Supergirl top. Again, keep the love alive. Macy, the 15-year-old.
We take a look at the live action here for Macy Callahan out in the lineup. She opened it with a 5.5. That's wave number two with priority now Malia Manuel. She opened up with a 3.83.
What do we have here? You ask yourself, a surfer in pink, Macy Callahan.
I'll tell you, Jesus, cannot do no wrong at all. Finds a section, finds a wave, get a little hard right there, pumps on the board. Now it's going to get a little rough, and she snaps off the top and makes it look so easy. Wave number three, a 5.50, a 2.83, and now will that replace her 2.83?
Oh, my best wave. I almost didn't go on that one wave. It was a one-turner, and it was a kind of a fairly larger wave of the heat, and so I just thought I should give it a go, and I got a one-turn wave, and it was, you know, luckily in my top score, and I'm just happy that I made that maneuver, because at first second I didn't think I was going to come out of that white water, but, you know, luck on my side today.
The quarterfinals are only half over. Who will advance, and who will be sent home? Find out when we come back. Only two more surfers will advance to the next round, but before we find out who they are, let's stop in with Lakey Peterson to find out what surfing means to her in this Essentia profile.
Hi guys, welcome to my San Clemente house. Come on in, I'll show you around a little bit. My vision for it was kind of to feel like you're on a boat, because it's really a small, tiny condo. Let's make a smoothie. First, crucial, for any smoothie, in my opinion, is a banana, chia seeds. Love chia seeds, really good protein, super good antioxidants. I'm gonna do a handful of kale and spinach. This is matcha whey protein. It's really good for like long-lasting, sustainable energy. For my ice cubes, I actually only use Essentia water to do my ice cubes. I think it's really important what type of water you're drinking, and Essentia's water, it is ionized and alkaline and kind of all I drink. So yeah, I always use their water to make my ice cubes. Then we're gonna take our almond milk, pour it in, and then we're ready to blend it. Pretty easy. So I broke my ankle in Ventura, California, just near home. Been out of the water for about 12 weeks. This was my first major injury. And it was definitely, it's been an eye-opening experience. It's super frustrating. You know, I'm a really active person. I love to obviously surf, but I love to train, I love to hike, I love to just be in the outdoors. And so to have that part taken away as well is pretty tricky and it was a big learning curve for me. Through that whole experience of, you know, not being able to do the things I so much love to do, I think in a way of reflection, it was good. Training outside of the water is super important. You know, with surfing, it's not a sport. You don't want to be big. You don't want to be super strong and muscly. That's not what you're going for. And especially as a girl, like, I want to be feminine and beautiful and, you know, and elegant, but also like have that sporty and badass side as well. Hydration is honestly everything. If you could eat as clean as you want, you could eat perfect, you could train perfect, you could do everything perfect, but if you're not drinking enough water, you're gonna tank. And I always think of water as like, if you're a car and you're not putting the right gas in the car, it's not gonna run well. You know, I wanna look back on my career one day and know that like I did everything I could to be the best that I could in my sport, and I didn't, you know, leave anything unturned. So I think in my head, that's a big part of it, just knowing that I'm doing everything I can. And when I put the jersey on to go compete, I know I've done everything I can. And that kind of just settles my mind, at least. Surfing's so unique. Someone said this one day and I thought it was such a great explanation for it. So like every wave you ride is basically your canvas. You can do whatever you want with that canvas. And however you think you should ride it is how you're gonna ride it. And you're trying to ride it to the best of your ability. Sort of like art, like they can paint the canvas however they wanna paint it. Surfing, you can do the same thing. You can ride the wave however you wanna ride the wave. You can be as creative as you want. You can be as stylish as you want. You can be as radical as you want. And whatever you think is the best way to ride that wave is how you're gonna do it. And that's why surfing is so cool, because everyone's got a different style, a different feel. You know, they're good or bad in different conditions and different things. So I think that's a really sweet part of surfing and what I do. And I also think the other thing is like, I don't know, everything just goes away when you're on a wave.
Brought to you by Essentia Ionized Alkaline Water. Get ionized with perfect hydration. Back at the Oceanside Pier and back to the quarterfinals. This time it's Caroline Marks against Carissa Moore.
Ooh, looky, looky. Nice, both ladies on the same wave. No issue with priority there.
I'm just gonna have fun, I'm just gonna surf. And I actually had the defending champ in my heat, so I was like, oh, no pressure on me, you know, but I obviously wanted to do good. So so that was really cool.
Hopping on through, generating the speed. Watch this final maneuver here. Gets in the inside, looks where it goes. Sends it vert while the body and the shoulder and the eyes and the head were right forward. Nice work.
Slowing down with the high tide and the swell dropping. So I don't take Caroline Marks lately. She's surfing really, really well. And I knew she could get a 7 pretty easily. So I didn't really like block her too bad, but I definitely wanted to be in her area just in case a really good wave came in.
Right now surfing in the water, the red, Caroline Marks. Yeah, oh.
My best wave was just the left that I did one move, and then luckily I was able to make the inside section, but I did like a little wiggle on the inside, nothing too exciting.
Taking a peek at Carissa Moore again. She's knocking off a chunk of this wave in the middle, and she'll do the same thing again. Hopping, moving the board back and forth, keeping it flat, generates the board speed, keeps it going for a maneuver on the inside like this, and does it again. She'll pop up and Give her a round of applause. You're going to hear.
For the final heat of the quarterfinals, it's Nikki Van Dijk versus Coco Ho.
Already we've seen one wave, Coco Ho with a 3.83. So priority shifting to Nikki Van Dijk, who has remained undefeated this entire contest, the 22-year-old in pink. Just generates some nice long turns, puts the rail work together, and take a look. Just solid footy. She's got a little double up here. Can she make it up and over the ramp? And she does. Into the inside. One nice hit. There you go, Nikki Van Dijk.
I am excited. I know I'll have Nikki, and we're both on tour, so it's kind of just going to be not even a QS heat name anymore. It's kind of like I got to think of it like it's a world tour heat, and we both really need the result.
Coco Ho. And a nice snap, lots of style, just about a full tail release. Coco Ho looking for that 6.10.
In pink with priority. She can take off whenever, wherever she wants, and she does just that. Races down, tries to get ahead and find an open face to do some art on. Not able to get it, but Coco Ho now has priority in white. She takes the next wave of that set. She goes on the heels to the back of the wave or her backhand. And then redirects it. Direction she is calling her front side, toes facing the wave, and she's on the inside. What does she have for us? Boom! Critically acclaiming that, Dave.
And that is how you do it.
She is a tactician in heat. She's very smart and calculated, and I'm kind of more just like go out there and surf. So, but I put on my best, my smartest heat pants.
From hundreds of girls, only four remain. And in Heat 1, it's going to be Malia Manuel versus Laura Enever. And Heat 2, Coco Ho versus Carissa Moore. Grab your spot on the pier or on the beach because you won't want to miss this. It's the semifinals. And up first, it's Laura Enever and Malia Manuel.
Here in California, the tides are so dramatic that it really filled up during my semifinal, and it was a little more challenging than I wanted to have it be.
Out the back, first wave for Malia Manuel.
Ooh.
If we take a look at Laura Enever, now Malia takes first priority. And in terms of coming into the number one world ranking on the qualifying series, well, we're taking a look at a lady. If she wins this heat, she will be number one in the world on the QS series. Takes a lot of pressure off her, and she has made the inside connection. Not only gets one, here's another little double up, this left, it's gonna bowl out off the top. Well, that's a tough landing, but boy, some nice turns all the way, Malia.
Had a couple opportunities. You know, Laura got that really good 6.5, and it was the highest score of the heat.
Well, here we go. It's not a now or never, but it's a now and Laura and ever. She's got to make it happen real quick. Couple of quick moves out the back, and now she's looking for where the energy is to bring it to the inside. This could be a kind of a breakthrough moment. Lots of speed, long section ahead, off the top, nice snap. A double section, she drops in again, and down she goes. So some gutsy moves right there.
And here we go. This is Malia Manuel. Still, just see the carving of the turns. What that does is helps her get right on shore, front and center. Let's hear a lot of Malia Manuel fans here. Oh, and that time, opposite of the lean back, she gets the nose dug in, but the consummate professional knows how to fall, how to take those diggers.
You know, she had priority, and so I think she had to kind of wait for that wave just in case it came and to take advantage of that opportunity, whereas I didn't really have that priority pressure, and so I could kind of hunt underneath and see what waves worked without, you know, losing that priority.
Yeah, just like waiting and searching for it, and just sort of waiting for a bit of a bigger set, but Malia got some fun ones under my priority, and so I kind of left my run a little late, but still stoked for the third place, and it's good to see all the girls surfing so well, and looks like it'll be an all-CT girl final with Malia and either Coco or Carissa, which is really cool, and it's good to be down here. It's a great day.
Well, it looks like it's going to be an all-Hawaiian final, and who's competing against Malia? Will it be Coco Ho or Carissa Moore?
The conditions in the semi were definitely a little slower. It was probably peak high tide, and I couldn't get over 3 for the first, like,
15 minutes?
The conditions are challenging. You know, the swell's on the decline. There's a little bit of wind chop, so it is a bit difficult to really perform at your best. But you just got to find the right one.
Well, here she goes, and Coco just being very aggressive and jumping on anything out there, because who knows what it's going to turn into. Absolutely critical wave for her on here. This is the wave number 5. And that backsize 3 works. Ooh. Nice move, very slick, and a real gutsy move. So she torques it around, and she makes the inside, 3-time world champion, and then pulls out. It gets a little fat, but slick move out the back. Let's see what the judges are going to think about that. She has matched Coco Ho's high score of a 3.33 with a 3.33. So the difference is now their second scores. Carissa Moore now needs a 3.10. Coco right here trying to better her 3.10. So very close. Coco's found some power. And to the inside, it doubles up, snaps off the top, and oof.
Ow.
Doesn't want to just annihilate that board. Just looking at the sand and the rocks. But some nice turns as she weaves to the inside. Coco has been busy.
This is the Supergirl, Carissa Moore. She takes one smack off the top and knows that that is all that wave has to offer. And she'll go back out. We set our sights on the lone surfer. Out back, here we go, Coco Ho. She goes down the line. One big turn, displaces some water, loosens up the fins, redirects it on her backhand, seeing what the inside will have to offer. And she is coming right at us. Come on, Oceanside, Coco Ho currently in the lead.
Impressive stuff right there for Coco Ho.
It meant a lot to me to get through to the final, and I definitely didn't take that for granted. That doesn't happen often in our sport. Only one person can get that cape. At least, you know, there's some Hawaiian representation.
Surfing, it's definitely special because it's not just in the water, out of the water, you have to be a great person.
If I wasn't surfing, I would probably be on the beach sitting watching surfing. I think it's the coolest thing ever. I'd probably be a professional beach spectator.
Okay, if I wasn't surfing, I would be hustling in college, trying to get A's.
I love that question, but it's so hard to answer. If I wasn't surfing, I'd probably right now be maybe at university studying something. I'm not too sure what it would be, but something, maybe with kids. I don't know, I just love working with kids and helping and in any kind of way to help the world. In a way.
Now seeing all the cool DJs down here, I would maybe have to try DJing as well, so.
I always just try to tell myself enjoy life day by day and yeah, just be daring and confident. That's what a Supergirl means to me.
My Supergirl is my mom. I'm pretty sure everyone's mom is their Supergirl, so she's been there for me 100% of the time and taught me everything I know, as well as my father, but he's not a girl, so.
The Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro was brought to you by Paul Mitchell Professional Salon Products. Paul Mitchell, live beautifully. By Fratelli's Italian Kitchen, Oceanside's best Italian restaurant and catering company. By Imperial Beer, La Cerveza de Costa Rica. And by ASA Entertainment, the leader in action sports event and television production since 1994. Visit us at asaentertainment.com. This is it. Two Hawaiians, one final, one cape. Will it be Malia or will it be Coco?
Surf against my best friend Coco. It's kind of a dream come true because we've been staying together and traveling around the world for the past couple of years on the CT. And we're always hoping that we're on the opposite side of the draw and that we meet up in the final, and it's kind of a dream come true for us today. So happy either way, you know, first or second.
I kind of had the worst start of both of us. She started with a 6, I started with a 3.
Well, here we go, opportunity here, no priority, inside position, and she draws first, and it is Coco Ho. Coco gets one good move out the back, another one, and now does have the energy to bring her to the inside.
And Malia Manuel on her first wave, on her backhand, gets right up top of that thing. And when you get up top, it affords you the opportunity to drop back down into it. And she's going to move that back and forth to keep her board speed up. right here, right now. She's looking for a little bit of your love. I know there's a fan club for Malia on Board Drops Down and executes properly. Good work, Malia.
I knew there was opportunity. I was like, just wait for a wave. It's a 30-minute final. You've already surfed 3 heats today. Don't waste your energy, was kind of my mentality.
And here goes Coco Ho. She throws it vertical off the top. She wraps it back around, gets into the pocket where the whitewash meets the cleaner water. And then she goes back towards the pier. She knows from experience that this is gonna regenerate and rebuild on the inside, moves the board back and forth, one maneuver, and able to hold on and show the commitment and the fortitude to hold on. Give it up, there's Coco Ho. Holding on strong.
That right came and I just got really lucky, you know, timed it and finished it and got a 9, but I knew the door was still open with Malia. She's been so hungry for a win this year. Once I got the 9, I knew it still, like, I still had to work hard.
Continuing on, Malia Manuel. She is gonna get that reform and she is not gonna get that one there. So Coco and Malia will position themselves back out there.
Made one or two mistakes. I kind of had two good rights and had an opportunity to, you know, capitalize on them, but didn't really go my way.
She needs an 8.34. She's earned a 6.17 and a 2.57. We know she's capable of more, just a matter of time.
Malia Manuel with priority. And on her backhand, she drops in, looks for a little bit of juice off the top. Nice snap. Redirects. Now, where do you go? Where are you to find it now? On her forehand, there's a double up. Is it going to get too fat? She tries to hop into it. No, she does. She makes the drop. Here's the double up section. Snaps off the top and jumps. And God, I tell you, that's a hard landing. A lot of rocks right there. Let's see what that's going to do for her.
To the beach. Here we go.
Well, take a look at that. Kind of bait and switch. We're not sure. But keeping her off the waves, showing that she wanted it. And she has used her priority to keep Malia Manuel off that first wave. Malia Manuel now takes first priority.
And there we go. Malia Manuel with 30 seconds left. All or nothing wave. Here she goes off the top. And trying to hold on to it. One good snap, but she needed to drop back down into the belly of that beast in order to make it.
Lucky for me, I held on to the lead with a 9 and a 5.5.
We are ready to count this thing down. Paul Mitchell, Supergirl Pro, almost in the record books in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Put your hands together, folks.
To lose to Coco is all right, because I respect her so much as a surfer, and I think she's has, you know, my favorite style on tour, so. You know, I can't complain.
I mean, it's just been such a whirlwind of a year for me on tour, and to be here in Southern California with all my friends and to be able to get the victory here, I think could be like the most special day of my life.
That's awesome. Well, we're stoked to be a part of it. There's so many people here on the beach. It's packed. Tell them a little something right to your fans.
Yes, I could hear all the support on the pier all day. Just hearing my name and all the cheers was such motivation, and it was really special, so thank you all.
She takes the win and also makes history. Congratulations to Coco Ho taking the pink cape for the third time. A very special thanks to the great partners that supported the event, including Terry Goodman and the entire City of Oceanside team. Visit Oceanside, Fratelli's Italian Kitchen, Extreme Athletics, J-Lab Audio, Master's Kitchen and Cocktail, iHeart San Diego, The Futon Shop, all of the tremendous performers on the Supergirl stage, the incredible women that participated in the female leadership panel, WSL North America, Lindsay Jacob Ellis, Amelia Brokaw, our amazing volunteers, and our dear friends at both Paul Mitchell and Warner Brothers. Thank you for watching the 2016 Paul Mitchell Supergirl Pro. We'll see you next year.
Hi, I'm Coco Ho from Hawaii, and I am a Supergirl.